Welcome to Edunguru students. I am Professor Devendra Chandrakar. I am very much sure that you have prepared well for your examinations, right? All the concepts are very clear to you. Now let's have a reality check, right? Let's check how much we are prepared for your examinations. To do this, we will solve some problems, right? Solving of these problems will help you to revise the concepts and it will bring you much closer to your goal, the most desired goal of yours, right? That is getting into the India's premier engineering institutes. So let's start with the session. We will be doing it chapter wise. Almost there are 30 odd chapters, but we will be giving more weightage to those chapters which are having more weightage in the examination. So let's start with the very first chapter. You will find one or two questions from this chapter usually in every year in IITs, right? So the first chapter is units and dimensions. We will be solving some 5-6 problems in it. They are segregated based on their difficulty levels. They will be treated as easy, moderate and tough levels in difficulty. You have to solve it along with me, right? And then we will match the answers. Okay, so let's take the first question. The pitch of a screw gauge is 1 millimeter and there are 100 divisions on its circular scale. When nothing is put in between its jaws, the zero of the circular scale lies 4 divisions below the reference line. So when a steel wire is placed between the jaws, 2 main scale divisions are clearly visible and 67 divisions on the circular scale are observed. The diameter of the wire is, option A, it's 2.71 millimeter, option B, it's 2.67 millimeters, option C, it's 2.63 millimeters, and option D, it's 2.65 millimeters. So the question is based on measurements, right? It's based on screw gauge. You are aware that you have to comprehend the data here. Pitch is given to you, right? Pitch is 1 millimeter. Number of divisions, N is equal to 100, right? This is 100 divisions. So first of all, we will try to find out what is the least count of the screw gauge, right? So least count LC is equal to pitch upon number of divisions. It's 1 upon 100 or it's 0.01 millimeters. So we have calculated the least count of the screw gauge, right? Now the zero of the circular scale lies 4 divisions below the reference line, right? So which type of error it is? You have to think like that, right? It's a positive zero error because zero line is lying 4 divisions below the reference line. So there is some reading in the screw gauge even when we are not measuring anything, right? So it's a positive zero error, right? Circular scale reading multiplied by least count. Circular scale reading is plus 4, least count is 0.01, so this is 0.04 millimeters, right? So now we have the zero error also. It's a positive zero error. Now let's read the diameter of the wire. It's given to us as the main scale reading. The main scale reading, or we call it as MSR, is equal to 2, right? So the least count of main scale is 1 millimeter, so it's 2 into 1 millimeter. We call this as 2 millimeters, right? We calculate it as 2 millimeters. Now, circular scale reading is equal to number of divisions is 67 multiplied by 0.01 millimeters. So it's 0.67 millimeters, right? So the observed reading, is equal to 2, that is the MSR, its main scale reading plus circular scale reading, it's 2.67 millimeters. Now, since it's a positive zero error, so the true reading is equal to 2.67 millimeters, that is the measured value, minus the zero error, that is 0.04 millimeters. So this is 2.63 millimeter is the diameter of the steel wire. So this is the correct answer. So C is the correct answer in this case. So correct option is C. The second question is, it says a student performs an experiment to determine the Young's modulus of a wire exactly 2 meter long, right? So the length of the wire is given to us. It's 2 meters long by Searle's method. In a particular reading, the student measures the extension in the length of the wire to be 0.8 millimeters. So change in length is 0.8 millimeters. Right, or we can write it as 0.8 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. See, while reading the question, you have to comprehend the data also, right? Then only you can send it to processing and then only you will get the outcome. So please remember, while reading the questions, you have to comprehend the data. Okay, so with an uncertainty of error in the extension is given to us as 0.05 mm. So we should write it as plus minus 0.05 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. Okay. Now at a load of exactly 1 kg, so mass is given to you as 1 kg, right? The student also measures the diameter of the wire to be 0.4 millimeter. So diameter D is 0.4 millimeter and delta D is with an uncertainty of 0.01 millimeter, right? So this is plus minus 0.01 millimeter. Now, take G as 9.8 meters per second square. The Young's modulus obtained from the reading is, okay. So the expression for Young's modulus in this case will be given as Mg, that is the load, divided by its force per unit area, that is the stress. Let me write it as stress upon strain, right? So stress is force upon area, that is pi d square upon 4, that is the cross section area of the wire. Change in length upon length is the strain, right? So Young's modulus Y is given to us as 4L mg upon pi d square delta L. This is the total length of the wire, capital L, and the change in length is small l. We have already designated these. This is capital L, this is the length of the wire, and this is the change in its length, right? Now, when we take ln of y, it's ln of 4L mg by pi, right, minus 2 ln of d minus ln of L. So we have, when we differentiate it, it's delta y over y. This is 2 delta d by d plus delta L by L. We are adding up. We are adding up the errors, right? So it's 2 into 0.01 divided by 0.4. This is the diameter, plus the uncertainty in extension is 0.05 divided by 0.8. This comes out to be 2 into 0.025 plus 0.0625. This is 0.05 plus 0.0625. This is equal to 0.1125. So change in Young's modulus delta y, or error in Young's modulus, is y into 0.01125. This is 2 into 10 to the power 11 is given to us. What we get here is it's 0.225 into 10 to the power 11. Right? Looking at the options, the correct option is B, which is 2 plus minus 0.2 into 10 to the power 11 Newton per meter square. So let's take up the third question. The question is, a highly accurate determination of G, that is acceleration due to gravity, has a coated error of 6 parts in 10 to the power 9, right? So it's given as that 6 parts in 10 to the power 9 is error in G, right? So it's delta G by G is equal to 6 upon 10 to the power 9. If the dependence of G on geographical latitude at sea level is given by G is equal to G naught 1 plus beta sine square phi. This is the dependence of G on the geographical latitude, right? Where phi is the latitude and beta is a dimensionless constant with a value of 0.0055. So beta is equal to 0.0055. We have to estimate the northward displacement near latitude 45 degrees. So when phi is equal to 45 degrees, we have to find the northward displacement, which gives a change in G equal to the quoted error, where radius of the earth capital R is given as 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 kilometers, right? The options are 6 meters, option B is 9 meters, option C is 7 meters, and option D is 12 meters. So how to solve it? We have to see what is the northward displacement, that is R into change in phi, right? R into change in the latitude. This is the northward displacement which we need to calculate, right? So it's dG. We have G naught times 1 plus beta sine square phi, right? So dG by d phi is equal to 2 G naught beta sin phi into cos phi. So d phi is equal to dg upon G naught beta into sin 2 phi, right? This is, we know what is dg by g. It's 6 into 10 to the power minus 9 divided by beta is 0.0055. And it's sine 2 into 45 degrees. This is 90 degrees. So this is 6 into 10 to the power minus 9 upon 0.0055. This is d phi. And this is equal to, 1.09 into 10 to the power minus 6 radians. Right? So x is equal to r into d phi. This is 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 multiplied by 1.09 into 10 to the power minus 6 meters. This can be approximated as 7 meters. It's 6.976. So it can be approximated as 7 meters. So this is the correct answer to this, right? The correct option in this case is C. Let's take another question. The fourth question is, a formula is given as pressure P is equal to, P is pressure, it is equal to B upon A, root of 1 plus K theta T cube upon MA, right? Where K represents Boltzmann constant, theta is temperature, T is time, A and B are positive constants, A and B are constants. Now whether they have dimensions or not, this is what we have to see. The question is, dimensional formula of B is same as the dimensional formula of option A is force, option B is linear momentum, option C angular momentum, and option D torque, right? So we have to find dimensional formula for B. Now you can see here, since it has to be added, this term has to be added to 1, so this entire term, that is K theta T cube upon MA, should be a dimensionless constant, right? So this is K theta T cube upon MA is a dimensionless constant. Right? The dimension for Boltzmann constant is ML square T minus 2 Kelvin inverse into the dimension formula for temperature is K, the dimensional formula for time is T cube upon mass is M. This is what is the dimension of A, right? So dimension of A, we get it as L square T. So dimension of A is L square T, right? The expression was pressure P is equal to B by A, and entire term in the root was, entire term in the root was a dimensionless quantity, right? So dimension of B is dimension of P multiplied by dimension of A. Dimension of P is the same as dimension of force per unit area, so it is MLT minus 2, MLT minus 2 upon L square into, this is L square T, right? So this cancels out, we are left with MLT minus 1, this is B. Now this is, this is kilogram, the unit is kilogram meter per second. This is the dimension of linear momentum, right? So the correct option is B. Let's take the next question. The question is, the edge of a cube is measured by a vernier caliper whose 10 vernier scale divisions coincides with 9 main scale divisions, right? And 1 main scale division is equal to 1 millimeter. So it's given to us that 10 VSD, that is vernier scale division, is equal to 9 main scale divisions. So one vernier scale division is equal to 0.9 MSD, and since 1 MSD is equal to 1 millimeter, so this is 0.9 millimeters. The main scale reads 10 millimeters, so main scale reading is MSR is 10 millimeters. And first division of vernier scale coincides with the main scale. Right. So mass of the cube is this 2.736 grams. Then we have to find the volume and density of the cube. Now, by looking at the options, you should guess that this can be a multiple option correct question. Right? Because there is volume in the option, there is density in the option. So first option is the volume of cube is in appropriate significant figures is 1.03 centimeter cube. Option B is the volume of cube in appropriate significant figures is 1.030 centimeter cube. Option C is the density of cube in appropriate significant figures is 2.656 grams per centimeter cube. And option D is the density of cube in appropriate significant figures is 2.66 grams per centimeter cube. Right? So this question is based on calculating the least count, how to read the readings from vernier scale, right? And then solving it to get the volume and density of the cube. So we have found the least count of vernier scale. Least count of vernier calipers is equal to 1 main scale division minus 1 vernier scale division, that is 0.1 mm. We will use this least count to calculate vernier scale reading, right? So measured value of edge of the cube is equal to its 10 millimeters plus 1 into 0.1 because 1 vernier scale division is coinciding with the main scale. So this is equal to 10.1 millimeters, right? This is the edge length A of the cube. So volume of the cube is, volume is A cube. So this is, it's 1.01 cube, it's centimeter cube. This is equal to 1.03 centimeter cube. The number of significant digits, right? So please remember it. So density is now, let's see whether any options of volume is correct or not. It's 1.03 centimeter cube. The first option is correct, right? There the significant digits are 3. So it's 1.03 centimeter cube is the volume of the cube in appropriate significant figures. So option A is correct. Now regarding density, density is mass per unit volume. Its mass per unit volume, so this is equal to 2.736 divided by 1.03. So this is grams per centimeter cube. So this comes out to be 2.6563 grams per centimeter cube. But we have to write the answer in three significant figures, right? So we have to round this off till here, till 5, right? So it becomes 2.66 grams per centimeter cube. This is density D. The answers which are correct are, or the options which are correct are option A and option D, right? These are the correct options. Now please remember that this question may seem to be an easier question to you, right? It's a case of moderate difficulty level. Why I call it as moderate? Because there are calculations involved. It will eat up your time, number one. The second is you have to constantly keep in mind the number of significant figures, because in the options you can see that it's 1.03 centimeter cube is there in option A. In option B, it's 1.030 centimeter cube is there, right? So numerically, both these values are correct, but we have to keep in mind the number of significant figures. So please remember this. In option C and D also, you can see here that it's 2.656 grams per centimeter cube, and it's also 2.66 grams per centimeter cube. If you will not pay attention to the number of significant figures, then you probably you can opt for all the answers, all the options. So this is what you have to keep in mind, right? So we have discussed altogether 5 questions in units and dimensions in this chapter, right? You have seen the questions will not be of very high difficulty level, but definitely the questions will be of easy to moderate difficulty level with calculations. In the next chapter, we will be moving ahead with kinematics, right? We'll be taking up questions in kinematics. We'll solve almost 10 to 15 questions in that also, which will give you a fair idea of the entire chapter. It will revise the chapter for you. So till then, thank you very much. See you in the next session. Goodbye.